Welcome back to Minute Med. In our previous video, we spoke about stable angina and its pathology. Here we will speak about the management of stable angina or the management of stable ischemic heart disease. Let's start with the general measures first. How should you advise a patient with stable angina? You should stop smoking, maintain an ideal BMI, treatment of diabetes and hypertension, advocate a healthy diet which is low in saturated fats, and avoid highly strenuous activities. So when we speak about the medications given in the management of stable angina, one of the main medications is antiplatelet meds like aspirin and clopidogrel. These meds are usually given upon admission, and what these antiplatelet meds do is that they reduce the risk of clot formation in the coronary arteries. The second type of medications are anti-anginal meds. Nitrates, beta blockers and calcium channel blockers come under this. Nitrates have a very important vasodilatory effect and it can allow more blood to pass into the heart. Beta blockers, on the other hand, have a negative inotropic and a negative chronotropic effect. They reduce the heart rate and reduce the myocardial oxygen consumption. They can also decrease the blood pressure by the vasodilatory effect. Calcium channel blockers reduce the calcium influx into the cell and decrease the myocardial contractility. This can also reduce the myocardial oxygen demand. Other medications like ACE inhibitors, potassium channel blockers, and HCN channel blockers are also used. If these medications don't work, then we have to go for more invasive management methods like angioplasty with a stent, which is also known as PCI, and coronary artery bypass graft. According to the National Institute for Health and Care Excellence, we can follow this basic algorithm in the management of stable angina. First, we can start by lifestyle modification and providing short acting nitrates to the patient. And then we can proceed to administering a beta blocker or a calcium channel blocker. But it's important to note that if beta blockers or calcium channel blockers are not tolerated or contraindicated, we should continue with long-acting nitrates. If the patient is still symptomatic or continues to have chest pain, we should switch the medications or give both beta blockers and calcium channel blockers. If there is still no response or no improvement, and if the patient is still symptomatic, we can administer two other anti-anginal drugs, for example, ivabradine, which is very common. And if that doesn't work, we should consider revascularization and go for the options of invasive management, either do an angioplasty with a stent or a coronary artery bypass graft. So let's speak about an example therapeutic formula. We could start the therapy with a low dose aspirin and give a statin, and also administer sublingual glyceryl trinitrate and also give a beta blocker. But if required, we could add a calcium channel blocker or add more GTN later if needed.